Mikey Garcia, one of the best pound-for-pound fighters on the planet, if not the best one. How did you score the Canelo Triple G fight?
I had 8-4 for Canelo.
That's a fucking Canelo fucking
right?
Fuck
that's true.
We're watching right the fight.
Yeah. But have you seen 90% of this month?
98%.
Okay, we're watching the fight the whole time, right? Maybe the first round.
There was like some random rounds.
It's like round, 12 rounds, maybe. The fight, you know? Like 8, 12, 11, 12, whatever. But anyways. Right before that, Joe was next to me and he said he's taking his
buddy. HBO has a winning.
HBO has Triple G winning. What? And then a few rounds later, they're saying Canelo needs a knockout to win. And I tell Pita, okay, check this. Is this like real? They're fucking with Joe. Pita checks online on his Twitter. Yup. People are saying the same thing. I'm like, are we fucking stupid? Like, we don't know shit about boxing, or what the fuck are we watching?
Yeah, like, we're like, what the fuck are we watching?
What the fuck
different?
Is going on?
Did you see Andrew Ward? So, I mean, Andrew Ward called it real, I mean, straight out. You know, he says Canelo won Triple G. He made Triple G back up,
yeah,
and he
the
fucking
whole night. Yeah, the whole night. Yeah. And then I just saw Canelo like in control the entire
night. Yes.
A few moments that Triple G had a few little moments of success, okay, but that was not enough to win the round.
No.
Because overall the round era de Canelo. Yeah. And even one of the last few rounds, I forget which round it was, that Canelo hit him, Triple G hit Canelo a little bit and the crowd went crazy. But it was just for like a small two punches, like small little moment. The rest of the round, Canelo was...
So why did 98% of media either have a Triple G or a draw?
I know a lot of people have it like
that. But all the fighters...
I watch it again, maybe. Maybe it's a little closer than when
But Mikey, all the fighters have Canelo winning. The media have Triple G.
Well,
so
if you're a fighter, you probably know a little more. You can read the body language. You can see the expressions. You can tell when punches... Canelo even hurt him with some body shots in a few rounds. And we could tell that he was hurt. Triple G was kind of like...
Let's see if Baby Bash...
What, see little things
how'd like you that. Score it?
I had Canelo 7-5, but that's because I wasn't a prisoner of the moment. I mean, late in the fight, I think the 10th or 11th round, I think Triple G hit him with some hard punches, and everyone, I think people tried, they didn't remember the first 9 rounds. You know, the first 10 rounds where Canelo was just pushing the issue. I mean, it's like, no one calls body shots anymore. It's like, people are allergic. I mean, they don't like to score body shots.
Now everybody wants to say the jab. Because of the jab. Jab, you see that jab.
Amateur rules is jab. I mean.
It wasn't even all that. I mean, I just saw Canelo dominate. I told Pita, you can see Triple G's age. You can see the wear and tear from all the fights.
And when I tell you about how when he fought fucking Rosado was when you fought Salido. Yeah. He's already 6 years older than you. You had 2.5 years in between where you rested.
And he was fighting,
three, four times a year. I was like,
you know,
poor
all
guy.
The training, all the sparring, all the wear and tear.
Not supposed to fight because Elie said like Ellie said like some of the fights like Vanes and some of the Kell Brooks, some of those fights were pretty easy for us.
Still,
I was like, but training camps. And I said, not just training camp, training camps with Abel fucking Sanchez
hard,
and Big Bear.
Fucking hard, you know, routines.
You get headaches in training, you get it like from hitting the head.
You're training, your body still takes the same toll.
Yeah.
You know, so
if diet, it's a one round fight, or you're still trained for 2 months. Yeah. You train your ass out for 2 months.
And they train hard.
And they train hard.
He trains hard.
Hard.
Fucking 4 minute rounds.
There, you can see the face, like an older fighter.
Yeah.
And then throughout the first couple rounds, I'm like, you know what? He looks like an old, burnt out fighter. All of a sudden, boom, that decline, you know, the age.
I told
and
you when
now he might fight and be like a stepping stone. One or two fights, and they beat him, and then he ends up retiring. Like, what I tell you was a
crusher, like Kobe.
No, after you could just see it, and now he's just like that.
Yep.
That's probably what's gonna happen.
Keeper. He might end up being
Okay, so what does Canelo do next now? He beat Triple G. Is there a third
rematch?
Fight? A rubber match, right?
I think they're both gonna do one in between. I think Golovkin's gonna go fight, what's his name?
In Japan,
Murata. Because they've been wanting to do that. Barbarian was mentioning that. It's in Tokyo Dome. They said there's a shitload of money you can make. Triple G against what's name. So they'll do that. And then I think Canelo fight like Lemieux or...
Can Triple G beat that fool?
Or Sonner. Yeah, Triple G will beat.
Yeah.
Murata's not that good. Murata's
Japanese
not
guy, that's a middleweight.
Yeah.
So maybe do that one. And then
you can Lemieux or Saunders.
Lemieux.
I think Saunders more Corleone, make him look worse.
I think Lemieux.
They'll got the Lemieux. And then they'll do the September. No, Triple G a year old?
Yeah, 1 year old.
Did you see Triple G fans burning his own shirt? I didn't think. I thought that was disrespectful. Yeah, after the fight, they were cursing at the Charlos, yelling puto, and then they took their own shirts off. There's a video where they, you know, they.
Yeah, people go crazy.
I think, you know, burning, you know, stuff down.
That's extreme.
People burn flags and whatever.
I'm just surprised there was fucking, like, I thought half, but Pita says no. I thought there was a lot of fucking Triple G fans.
Yeah, but no, no.
Canelo had
the, had more? Yeah. Okay, well, okay. Yeah, a third of it, whatever.
But yeah, he, okay. Triple okay. G had a lot
and,
of fans.
And more, and 99% of those were Mexican. Going for fucking Triple G.
You didn't see any people from Kazakhstan. You didn't see about Mexican.
Fucking, you know who was there? From Oxford, what's his name? Asar, ¿cómo se llama?
Yeah, Medimen.
Medimen.
LeBron James was there.
Going for Triple G, that was it.
De la Salmoni.
Oh, so they got mad.
Yeah, they probably.
Well, either way, I thought Canelo, hasta we even said, está luciendo el cabrón. He's fucking looking great.
You didn't see no guys from Kazakhstan with cheering for Canelo.
But Canelo didn't run, he didn't box, he came, bro.
What they asked for.
So I want to ask every reporter that scored it for Triple G to explain themselves.
Yeah,
because I don't understand.
I thought Canelo won easy. I'm telling you.
If they can't score,
Teddy Ellis, all he has to say is that jab. The fuck with that jab?
What does Teddy Ellis know about boxing?
It wasn't even that effective.
That jab.
No, it was more effective. If it would have been something that you're fucking, hey, just tell you, and he can't even get close, and Canelo can't even get close, well, okay, then it's effective. But if Canelo's still landing punches, still hurting him, you know, beating him up.
I want Harold Letterman before, if you ever just...
Yeah, 116, 112 in favor of Triple G.
I want him to score your old fights that you've knocked people out to see if he still gets the score right.
Dude, I don't know how he had a...
How'd they do 116?
That's, I don't know. He gave like the first 3-4 rounds.
Yeah.
Like a weirdo.
No, maybe the first one. Maybe round one.
Yeah, maybe the first
one. You can give it round one.